is ascending and pulling us up with it.
Yes.
And that it is a conscious being, as is, you know, as are all the planets. And that the sun's timing its release of these electromagnetic pulses to free us from the constraints of the electromagnetic grids that have been keeping us in place and keeping us dumbed down and unaware, and also keeping the veils in place in between
right.
densities.
Yes, yeah, and so I was thinking about that, you know, after listening to this program, too, and I thought, well, we have an electromagnetic grid around us, you know, and I said, that's like keeping us in prison. And so if that all of a sudden went down, we would be open to multidimensional consciousness.
Yes, and telepathy, empathy, we could be, you know, because look at all of the natural world is connected except for us. You know, we're not able to tap into each other's thoughts, but look at how the birds fly in formation and they know exactly where they're going. You know, I mean, you could go on all night about that. And, so many people say that the next step for humanity, and we're due for, a major evolution, is that we will be aware of each other's intentions. And not necessarily able to read each other's minds because we'll have privacy, but we will know what's in the heart of other people.
Yes, right.
And
so I
will, that will eliminate
I think that
a lot of
excuse me. I think that there's something going on right now with a lot of people are expressing what they think they're having a heart attack.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and so, it's like, especially like before earthquakes or something like that, you know. And so I know I had a friend that called me up and said that she was just really afraid because she thought she was having a real one. It was right before Haiti had the earthquake, and I had the same thing. But I think that a lot of people, our heart chakras are opening because our heart chakras have to be open. You know, because they've been so closed down for such a long time because of all the lessons and the trauma and the sorrow and everything that everyone that's been living on the earth has had to go through.
Yes.
And so people just automatically close down their heart chakra to protect them from all of the negativity that goes on earth. And so now we're in a process of the heart chakra opening up.
Yes.
And so in some people, this can be really painful. And
well,
so I've gotten emails with several people. They've been having what they consider heart attacks right before the earthquakes happen.
Wow.
And before it used to be body pains and stuff like that, and now it seems to be affecting the heart.
Well, that's a good sign, though, isn't it? I mean, as long as have a heart attack.
Yeah, right. Yeah, it just, you know, hurts and it feels like it's happening, but it's not really. I mean, you know, I mean, well, some people have, I mean, they do have heart attacks, but all of the earth sensitives that feel all these things that are going on, you know, when they feel something like that, the biggest chance is that it's your heart chakra opening.
Well, now, what about the timing of this film Avatar coming out? I haven't seen it yet, but there's quite a bit of talk about it being a significant movie for this period of time.
Oh, it's a wonderful movie for this period of time. There's a lot of violence in it, you know, with the U.S. shooting up everything, but that kind of had to be in there to balance the movie out to really get the message across. And the message I got from it is that everyone is tired of wars and they want to live like the blue people live in the movie, which is one with everything, one with the forest and the park. They have these just gorgeous, like flowers and this forest where they live, it's just beautiful. And then if you see it in IMAX, you know, like these flowers will come out at you and you're like right there.
Wow.
And it's just amazing. And then the guy that's talking about an avatar, you know, it's like he goes into this what looks like an iron lung, and then or maybe a MRI or something like that, you know, trying to describe it. And then he goes from being as an American soldier into being into the body of one of the natives. And then so he's living kind of like a double life.
Wow.
And then he ends up being their avatar. And then when the United States goes in to destroy all their habitats, then he becomes the savior, you know, and
wow.
And then they win. Well, nobody wins in a war, but the thing is that the ones who fight are totally gone. You know, they end up just destroying themselves, and then it shows at the end where this other group of people, aliens, you know, they can live in peace and harmony now. And so that kind of goes along with where we are right now in
right
prophecy.
Right now, yes.
Right,
isn't
yeah.
Isn't that interesting? And the Hindu gods were blue.
Yeah. Yeah, and they're tall beings, and it was just so interesting watching it, for me anyways, to see how they portrayed it. And then they had, like, this one ceremony they had. They were sitting in the forest, and they were all in a circle, and they were all swaying together, you know, and they were one.
Wow.
And they could talk to the trees, and they could talk to the animals, and it's the way the world should be.
Should be. I think that's where we have been. And through technology and through drops in frequency, we've lost touch with that. And we're at the lowest ebb right now before the dawning of the new age. And when we reconnect and realize that there is no separate person, we're all interconnected, and you can't really do anything, you know, in a selfish manner, because what you do affects everything.
And, yeah, that's true. Yeah. And I read the Harry Potter series, you know?
Oh, yes. It's a wonderful. Yes.
Yes, and it was so interesting too, because you know, it's all about magic and all that kind of stuff, but the last book really held me, you know, where I couldn't put it down. I had to keep reading it, because that portrays what's going on in the world too.
Right now,
because,
yes.
Yes, because in the very end, you know, they were, the dark side was there, you know, and was chasing them around. But at the very end, Harry Potter and all of his friends, who, like the Avatar too, you know,
right.
And all of his friends, they were like fighting against the dark side for the control. And in the very end of that book, like, Harry had to stand up to the Dark Lord, you know, at the very end, and then how it works out is negativity destroys itself, and so then the Dark Lord was destroyed by, you know, how it works, by the negativity, and then it was like the ending of it was then Harry Potter and his friends all got to live in peace and security, because
wow.
There was no more war.
Well, I do believe that those books are channeled.
I think so, too.
Yeah, and the, you know, especially with the idea that the dark side is infiltrating into the highest echelons of the, you know, into the secret services.
Yes.
You know, there's a direct correlation there between, you know, MI, whatever it is, 5, 6, or 12, or whatever, and the different CIA agencies and all that the dark side has infiltrated into all these different places and is waging its war from the inside of it now.
Yes.
So, you know, I think that's that children can read that and they understand it at an intuitive and empathic level, especially with all the, you know, indigos and crystals and the new kids that are around that.
Oh,
you know,
yes,
they get
yes.
It now. They just get it.
Right, yes, because there's been like different types of people that have come in, and like I know, like I saw a long time ago, that there were the light workers that came in, and like the light workers are a different race than the people of love, you know?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And so how it works in the galaxy is the light workers come in, because light is intelligence and wisdom,
mm-hmm.
and knowledge and teaching.
Mm-hmm.
And so they came in, and they brought all the knowledge, like you know, so many of the people that have come in have done over the years, and they've educated the people as to what is going on.
Mm-hmm.
And then, when the time is right, then the children that are coming in, they're love children. They're children of love.
Right.
And so the love race is the ones that will set up the new system.
Yes, yes. And they're just about poised to be in a position to assume those roles now.
Yes.
you know, if not overdue.
Right.
You know, yeah. Because the indigos were coming in, you know, a long time ago, and they've had kids, and their kids have had kids, so, you know, if they're not ready to step up to the plate, well, then it'll be their great-great-grandchildren that will be doing it. So,
right,
and
yeah.
I don't think that's the case because time accelerates according to the Mayan calendar and Terence McKenna's work and so many other people who have researched it, that we're moving into an accelerated period. So we're reliving so many periods in shorter cycles. They're spiraling around.
Yes, right. And I believe that time is a manifestation of the fourth dimension.
Yes. Yes.
And then when we get in the fifth, there'll be no time.
No time. So, you know, when people are frightened about the no time thing, they're assuming that that means something terrible or bad. But
oh, no.
The dropping of the density that restricts us to the illusion of time.
But to be able to live in the now.
In the now, yes, in a higher spiritual form.
Because that's all that really matters. Yeah, that's all that really matters is living in the now.
Right, exactly. And we're so busy, we've been kept so busy, you know, having careers and jobs and working for corporations. And you can see how corporations have taken over the world. It's obvious.
Right.
You know, they run the world now. And
that's right.
You know, what, 6 or 7% of the world now owns over 90% of it. So, you know, the world domination game is over. So
yes, right. So 20th chapter.
Oh, okay. Now, do you want to go into some of the things that how the fall occurs in the 20th chapter?
Well, basically, it kind of starts with the fall, with the war against everyone. So, I mean, all the ships gathering over there, and so I don't know exactly how that will happen, but I just know that it talks about. Well, the way it's worded in the Bible is kind of difficult for a lot of people to understand,
uh-huh.
You know, and it just says that the serpent will be in the devil, you know, they'll be bound for 1,000 years, you know,
uh-huh.
And it's just like they'll be thrown into the lake of fire.
Yeah.
And
metaphoric
so,
language.
Yes,
not literal.
All metaphoric, so you can't really take it out
right.
There, but it's basically, my interpretation is the downfall of the controllers, and this goes along with Pluto and Capricorn, because
oh.
Capricorn is a sign that rules governments, it rules corporations, it rules structures, you know, like all the structures that went down in Haiti.
Mm-hmm.
And the
mm-hmm.
structures, like the corporations and the
mm-hmm.
businesses, and so Pluto being the transformer, the old way of doing business has to be transformed. You know, like look at Toyota; they're having to totally revamp their whole system, and that's a huge company.
Oh yeah,
because
yeah.
of the brake problem or the gas pedal problem.
And unfortunately, it's still business as usual for the other companies because all they do is just add a lot more features on the inside of their cars. But the basic, the core change, the shift, the paradigm shift that has to happen, is a shift to you know, electrics or you know a different technology entirely. And you know, those people who are in the know that technology has existed for over 50, 60 years. It's just been held up, and those patents have been bought up, and they're sitting on shelves in various corporations, and they're just not, you know, they use it for themselves, but they don't release it because we have to have wires to connect us so that they can meter the electricity, and we have to be dependent upon oil.
Right. And that's why the controllers have to be out of control.
Yes.
So
well, they are out
freedom.
Of control. they're pathologically out of control now. I bet they need to just go.
Right, yeah. Well, the new earth that I've seen, and this is what's kept me going with doing the prophecies and everything for so long, is that I think that what I saw was the fifth dimension world because there were no cars.
Mm-hmm.
No concrete.
Mm-hmm.
There was a transportation system,
mm-hmm.
but it wasn't, you know, like what we have now. Everything was green, lush, probably just like the Garden of Eden.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And so that's what, you know, just, I thought, oh, wow, I want to be on that earth.
Absolutely. I agree with you totally. And, you know, even one of my guests, was on a while back, Andrew D. Bajago, And he was part of Project Pegasus, which was one of those other underground operations.